Where is God? He's right in front of you. In Romans chapter 8, Paul says, if God is for us, then who can be against us? Today, we might ask the question differently. If God is with us, then where is He? Many faithful Catholics, and not a few of the unbaptized, often ask this question. We live in a difficult, at times tragic, and highly polarizing era. What St. Paul rhetorically asked some 2,000 years ago, we can ask today. But depleted of the early missionary zeal St. Paul and the first century Christians enjoyed, we might be more tempted to ask simply, where is He? Where is God? Scores of sociological and psychological studies done in the past half century have reminded us of man's continuous search for meaning and purpose in this world. And in the Second Vatican Council, the Church once again clearly stated the purpose of all life is infinite and joyful union with the Blessed Trinity. Man's infinite longing for meaning in this life comes from his natural desire for God, to know the good, the true, and the beautiful. So where is He? Where do we encounter Him? We see in the life of the Church that the preeminent way in which we encounter Christ is through the gift of Himself and the worship we offer God, Father, Son, and Spirit, and through the invisible grace conferred by these visible and efficacious signs instituted by Christ and administered by the Church, what we commonly call sacraments. Sunday after Sunday, and really every day, Christ substantially and visibly reveals Himself to us in the holy sacrifice of the Mass, the forgiveness of sins in the sacrament of reconciliation, and in the faithful living out of one's vocation. So why do we scratch our heads, looking at the stars, wondering where He is? We tend to forget that God, who is all-powerful, all-knowing, and all-loving, tends to not overwhelm us with Himself, because He is a gentle and loving Father. Rather, as the history of Israel testifies to in the Old Testament, He gradually and subtly reveals Himself through the prophets, the judges, and finally through the incarnation of His only begotten Son, Jesus Christ. And because Christ knows us better than we know ourselves, He knew that when He ascended into heaven, we would continue to look for Him, to encounter Him, and to yearn to be with Him. Perfectly aware of this, He established seven sacraments. Once again, these are outward, visible signs instituted by Christ and administered by the Church to give grace through His Church that will remain until He comes again in glory. When you look at the Church's work, the hospitals, the shelters, the schools, and all of the many things she is involved in, you have to see what lies at the heart of it all is the love of God that pours forth from Christ's continuous presence to us in the sacraments. The grace given to us by the sacraments conforms us more intimately to the heart of Christ, to the heart of the Blessed Trinity, and in turn is poured out by us into the world in our charity to our neighbors. If you are looking for Him, open your eyes to the source of grace in the sacraments. Every time they are celebrated in what we call the liturgy, the grace that flowed from Christ's side on the cross in blood and water is once again poured out and applied to us, the members of His body. The literally life-saving efforts we make to avail ourselves of worthy and noble celebrations of the liturgy, especially the Most Holy Sacrifice of the Mass, will continually conform us more deeply, inside and out, to the God who loves us and calls us to be like Him. Next time you are tempted or hear someone say, if God is with us, then where is He? Go to Mass. Go to confession. Attend a wedding, even if you don't know the people. And there you will find Him, who loves you more than you love yourself. God bless you.
I'm Bishop Joseph Strickland. Thank you so much for viewing this episode of the Way of Christ is an excellent resource for growing in your Catholic faith, for deepening your life in Jesus Christ. You can purchase your own copy of The Way of Christ at stphilipinstitute.org/store. God bless you, and let us continue to grow in His light.